let's share the word of God.
Arabuleleng lintjula modi.
Testimony says, God wants to bless you.
Modi monyakoli shufat.
Forget the past.
Levalang chakhan.
Failures.
Upalelo achan.
God loves you.
Modi mualerata.
Can we read?
Kariyo yuba.
In Matthew 9.
Matthew 9.
36, I won't talk long.
Ngasubulele na kuitelele.
Matthew 9.
Matthew 9.
Verse 36.
Verse 36.
Let's read 36.
Ariango verse 36. Matthew 9.
When he saw the crowds, he was moved with compassion and pity for them, because they were dispirited and distressed, like sheep without a shepherd.
Re a bona mashaba abathu abashokelwa ka gobane ba be ba lapile ba lahletswe wa dingko tse di senago modiša.
Let's read 37. Then he said to his disciples, the harvest is indeed plentiful, but the workers are few. So pray to the Lord of the harvest to send out workers into his harvest.
Abolela le baruti wa ba gawe re ponoki enchi me badire abanene ka gona gopelang mongwa pona a romele badire ponong ya gagwe.
Can we pray? Thank you, Lord, for your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
You know, I just want to talk about the compassion of God, of our God. It's only when I read here, I found the meaning of compassion. There are two words, dispirited and distressed. Maybe we can understand this word if we understand the work of a shepherd. A shepherd is a person who takes a sheep where they will be satisfied. But now these two words shows that there was no life for the sheep. In their spirit, they were tired. They've been searching. They were having double stress.
This means
they were longing. Have you ever reached a level whereby
when
you are searching for something, you reason, also you don't find solution? When I read this, I found that
it's
where there's no shepherds. So when Jesus looked at them, he said, we are lacking shepherds. People's spirit are tired. Because they've been going places searching for solutions. And they are troubled. So let's look at the compassion. He said, let's pray so that the Father will provide. That is the issue of the compassion.
If we pray,
our Father will bring those people so that we won't feel pity or
fear.
Let me say this to you, maybe you'll understand
it.
A Christian without a pastor is a sheep without a shepherd. A Christian without a pastor. It's a sheep without a shepherd. Look at this verse we are reading.
Maybe
you will understand that it was so painful because here
Kaori mo.
The Bible says Jesus saw the crowds.
Bible o bona masharo ba Bible re Jesu a bona batho ba malishana.
What makes him to talk? He was moved.
Nto ye na idirile ngore a ta bolele o ila ba le kwelo botlhoko.
And had pity with them.
A kwa ba shokelwa.
Compassion is there.
Kwelo botlhoko itenge.
So that there will be solution.
Udiela robele dikarabo.
Without compassion there's no solution.
A kwelo botlhoko isiyo ona ka.
I've read about Jesus several times.
Ke batile ka Jesu.
I realized that it was out of his compassion that he did things. Can I tell you this? The place where compassion works well is when someone is trapped. Let me say it again. Compassion work well when someone is trapped. This shows that we are trapped. We can't get out from the trap. When God look at us, he says no one can come and release us. So that's where the compassion of God moves. I don't know you're hearing me. Okay, look at this verse. In Mark 8 verse 1. If you read Mark 8 from verse 1,
Mola o mareka 8 o tloga go verse 1,
you find Jesus
rewana Yesu
performed the miracle.
A chikoita matembe.
Let's read there.
Ari ma,
because he saw what will happen.
Ngauri o bona zwa chikotoite.
Mark 8,
mareka 8
verse 1. In those days when there was again a large crowd gathered before him, it's another day of the large crowd. They had nothing to eat. Jesus called his disciples, told them, I feel compassion for the crowd. They have been with me now for 3 days and have nothing left to eat. If I send them away to their homes hungry, they will faint. Can you see what compassion is? Look here, compassion, when you have it, you know what will happen. In other words, you cannot have compassion with someone unless you can foresee what will happen. You know, if you want God to help us today,
it's
for God to give us compassion. Because compassion brings spiritual eyes to see. Jesus saw that if he leave them, they will faint on the road. And he had been with them 3 days. And because of compassion, he said, let me solve the problem before it comes. That is not compassion. If you solve a problem and another one rises, that is not compassion. Compassion deal with the problem and also uproot it out. Because you can see Jesus said, no, if I leave them, they will faint on the road. What I need to do, let me solve the problem they will encounter on the road. Can you see what compassion is needed? Because when you are working like this, you don't know what will happen. But with compassion, you can see what will happen and solve it before someone encounters it. I don't know if you're hearing me. Ask somebody, say, my friend, do you understand compassion? So, the Bible shows that God is having compassion. Because he knows your journey before you start. If we read Ephesians 1, especially 3 and 4, he says,
verse 3 and 4,
he predestined us in love. He set the end before you start to move. He knows your journey. So, compassion of God is to make you not to meet troubles you don't know.
Even what you know.
Look Sometimes you must understand that God has loved you before you love
him. And
he placed you where he knows
that you can make it,
but you are trapped
there.
So because of compassion,
he
wants to remove you from
there.
The compassion of God is so much for us that we can't die in our
trials.
We can't fall when people want us to fall. Because when you look at us, you provide solution before time. If you believe, shout
amen.
Passion is, don't judge things or judge other people. Put yourself, if you put yourself in someone's position, you will hate to hurt someone. You will ask forgiveness all the time. I don't know if you hear me. You will ask forgiveness before trouble comes. But if you just say, no, that one is that one, me, I'm here. You see, you'll be like a Levite. Or this other one. Who's a priest? Having a position without a character. At the end of the day, Jesus is considering people by their response.
Tell somebody,
my friend, you are considered by your response. How many of you are hearing that? Before you insult someone, go yourself or your mirror, insult yourself. You realize that what you are feeling is what another person can feel. And if you see that, don't do it. I believe if you people can practice compassion, you will solve many problems. Look what I did now. I felt compassion. And I was driving my car, I went to a stop sign.
You know, when stop signing,
I found what is compassion. Compassion makes you to prefer other people than yourself. The moment when I reach on the stop sign, I look at this one, I say, you can pass. That one says, pass. That one pass, another one says, pass. You see this stop sign of stop sign.
Yeah, when I did stop sign, the church will stop on my
you know, like this. Four cars are facing each other.
The stop sign in the land in the four.
So when I was three, pass.
I can repeat.
This one
behind
say, And I realize there are some places where the rules are needed. Because compassion is above any rule. You destroy any rule. And you don't hurt anybody. I don't know if you hear me. Compassion of someone. Jesus said, go and constantly do the same. Feel what other people are feeling. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's read Exodus 33. From 17 to 23. There are things that tell us we need to ask God. There are things, some things.
Exodus.
Let's go to Old Testament.
More Testament.
How many of you are feeling compassion of other people? If you feel that compassion, God will bless you because of compassion. Let's read Exodus 33 verse 17. He says what?
Amen.
The Lord said to Moses, I will also do this thing that you have asked, for you have found favor, loving kindness, mercy in my sight.
Amen.
And I have known you personally by name.
Amen.
Then Moses said, please show me your glory. And God says, I will make all my goodness pass before you, and I will proclaim the name of the Lord before you, for I will be gracious to whom I will be gracious.
Amen.
And I will show my compassion, on whom I will show compassion.
Amen.
But he said, you cannot see my face, for no man shall see me and live. Can you see that?
Amen.
Here, God was showing that compassion is what God applies in our lives. We are not seeing what we are seeing because we are better than others. It's the compassion of God. Sometimes when God lifts someone, don't ever think you are there because you are better than others. It's compassion of God. Let me give you an example before I talk about this. The one who wrote 3/4 of the New Testament, he never repented because somebody preached on him. It was compassion. God visited him. And Jesus came there by light. He followed
them.
His eyes were blind. God did something to make him to repent. Can you see the compassion of God? Sometimes God allows some things to happen for the sake that we believe in. So it happens to Moses also. When Moses realized that God is with him, he was not aware that that was the compassion of God.
Even
him, he was chosen from sin. He ran away from Pharaoh. After he killed someone. But because of compassion, God followed him there. Your salvation is not because of your ability. Your confidence in doing things does not even matter. Whatever you receive is by compassion of God. Where you are is because God wants you to be. I don't know if you're hearing me. When he sees that, he said, God, can I see your face? He asks things that God refer him back and say, yes, you can see my glory, not my face. And you are just allowed because of compassion. Not because you are fit for something.
No
wonder Moses was a humble person.
That is why Moshana le
God taught him that, can you see? You were saved by my compassion. You can't talk. You are not fluent. You have a stammering tongue. I make you a leader of Israel.
And
so out of my compassion, I make you to be. There were better people than you, but I chose you. So therefore, some things when we ask will be allowed by compassion of God so that we receive them. It's not because we are prayed. Careful. I don't know if you're hearing me. As I say, my friend, you are not having what you are having now. Because things works better. It is the compassion of the living God. Listen. We need Christians who must understand that whatever we have, what has happened, whatever, is God's compassion. It's not because of our ability or our failure. As long as we are in the Lord, when you are in the Lord, you will understand that God has loved you. That's why he has allowed this. Remember, the Bible says everything works for good. Everything works for good. Poverty for good, life for good, death for good, sickness for good, everything. So whatever you are going through, it's because God has allowed it. If not, you cannot see it. I don't know if you're hearing me. Some people, you will be surprised. You know, you pray useless prayers. It's as good as today. Yeah. I can give you something that will shock you. You'll be surprised to say you want to change your life. But why don't you change parents?
What was that change about kutom.
If your prayers are working, will change parents. God allowed you to be born there because of compassion. And there's a purpose of God for your life there. Whatever that is happening there, in a poor family, in a rich family, in well-to-do family, God wants to show compassion. It's not because you are born in a poor family, because you are fit to be there. There's a reason of God. He wants to show his compassion. I don't know if you're hearing me. So your prayers can't change everything. Tell
everybody,
your prayers can't change everything. So there's no way you can just wake up and say, I want my being to be like this. I mean, we have prayed too much, but we don't change our face. We always resemble the parents. I don't know if you're hearing me. You are praying so much, but because of the compassion you've been given from the beginning, you are supposed to be born. You are better than the one who died. Now you are alive. You can breathe. So you can think, you can meditate, you can plan. So what you are planning, God can allow it or not, or he can deny you or not. It's not because you are better, but if you stay in his presence, God's compassion will work for you. God's compassion is the purpose of God for you to be around here. That is God's compassion. Shake somebody say, hey, God's compassion is the purpose of God for you to be around here. Not to be changed from here. Can you shake somebody and say, do you understand God's compassion? So you decide. You just decide. You decide to follow God or not. If you hold on him, and God's compassion, whether you are a Samaritan, a Levite, or what, doesn't matter. What matters is what you are supposed to do. If you do it, God of heaven will consider you. So your position, where you put yourself, doesn't matter. What matters is what God wants you to do. If you carry on doing it, the purpose of God, because of the compassion of God upon your life, will happen in your life. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Look at Proverbs 28 verse 13. It says, he who conceals his transgression will not prosper, but whoever confesses and turn away from his sins will find compassion and mercy. In other words, compassion comes when you live right. In Proverbs 28, verse 13, it shows
Proverbs 28, 13,
compassion comes when you live right. In other words, God
I'm
will just say, ish, I have whom is living right. And remember, our righteousness are not even befitting the righteousness of God.
So
even if we try to live right, we cannot convince God. I'm sure you understand that. So you just say, I have this one, I'll share. I'll
share.
God can say, I'll share. I have Makananisa, I'll share.
It's
preaching the gospel, shame. Shame. Let's give him this. Shame. In other words, there's nothing that was suitable for us. That's where, when we talk about compassion, we understand that the grace of God has worked. I'm sure you understand that.
Huh? Amen.
So, you know, it takes you to understand that, oh, the grace of God has taken me to where God will bring his compassion to work for me. Because the moment God consider you and put you to a place where you'll be blessed, that's grace. But the provision comes by compassion. I'm sure you understand that.
So
if you know that every day, you will do what Paul says, work out your salvation every day. Every day you just say, no, I don't want to be left behind. I don't want to preach the gospel tomorrow. I'm talking about Paul who was anointed. He said, I don't want to preach the gospel tomorrow, I'm lost. I'm thrown aside. I'm sure you understand what I'm trying to say. Look at this verse, Psalm 62, verse 12. It says, you are compassionate by everything you do. Every man according to the value of work, the kindness of God, compassion of God, will look what you are doing. Every work, and God will say, shame.
Yes,
we have this pastor.
At least,
you know, sometimes heaven come together and say, like what they spoke. And say, we have
job.
It's not defiling himself.
It's upright.
So Satan says, I know.
Satan,
we want to claim him.
So
he said, God said, do what you can do, but don't kill him. And from there, trouble come. Sickness. Children died. Because sometimes you ask yourself, is God with me when I'm losing children? And you find that God is aware. Yes, I'm looking.
Oh,
shame. He's still standing with me this
way. At least you can
see
him
standing with me. Going to heaven is not just play. It's from compassion. You can still come to church, you
go,
you die in heaven. God must look at you and
say,
this person must not die in heaven. It's not because you say, I'm confident I can do this. There's nothing you can do before God.
Nothing.
I'm sure you understand that. So therefore you can work out your salvation every day. You understand that it's God who decides. I don't know if you're hearing me. That's what I say, my friend. God is looking on every work you do. By his goodness and his compassion, he will reward you. I'm sure you understand that.
Amen.
So therefore, we will carry on working because we believe in him. We know he will do something. There's someone here who's doing something for God. Can I tell you this? The compassion of God is coming upon you. The mercy of God is coming upon you. If you believe, shout hallelujah. You must understand compassion. Can I give an example? Huh?
Amen.
When you are not feeling pain, that does not mean that you are not sick. I'm sure you understand that. So, that's the compassion of God. It works that way. You might be very close to death than somebody who's in hospital. But God sometimes does not allow you to feel pain because he's looking on your face. There is nobody on earth using 2 feet who's 100%. Because you are using the soil and you are connected to this world.
And your body
has been created from this soil. It gets tired. And Satan sometimes claims it.
Satan,
so you cannot rectify yourself and say everything is fine. You just believe in him and trust in him and carry on doing what is right. Not entering by mistake. Let us not use, you know, God will feel pity of me and I enter heaven. No. You must do something. Do something in the house of God. Serve him, pray, worship him. The moment you do that, heaven talks about you. You are considered. They begin to say, how can we make this person to go up? If you want to see, look at the life of Cornelius, who was giving, loving Israelites, doing whatever. And heaven said, oh, let's send the angel. Let's send the angel to speak with
him.
Because he's lacking something. Can I tell you this? If heaven find what you are lacking and provide it, it's because of the compassion of God. I don't know if you're hearing me. The compassion of God also must teach where you are lacking. Must teach your weakness so that you rectify it and able to stand for God. But if you always hit your chest, if you want people to praise you, you can miss heaven too. You can miss His loving kindness. You can still live and people praise you, but at the end you realize you're not living your life. There are some people who are listening to me today here. You've been doing good for God. I'm here as I'm pointing at you. Today God is honoring you. God is honoring you. The compassion of God is searching for you in the name of Jesus. If you want to see that, remember what Jesus said. Jesus said, the first shall be the last, and the last shall be the first. You know, when I read about that, I troubled. I'm very much troubled on that, because sometimes you can still say, I'm standing, as you have fallen. Jesus was saying, hey, there's no issue of guaranteeing yourself when you're on this road. Every day work. Every day understand that temptation will come, problems will come, challenges will come, but you must know that you have Jesus, the author and the finisher of your faith. You carry on holding, you carry on believing, you carry on trusting, and something will happen later. If you believe, shout hallelujah. We need to check our level. If we are still on the same level or not. Or are we going up, or what is it that is putting us down? It's of pointless to come to church, praying, fasting, doing whatever, later we found ourselves not achieving anything. I speak compassion of God in your life. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Look here, even Jesus himself, he did many things by compassion. Look at it. Let me show you. In Matthew 9:27-31, there were two blind men there. In Matthew 9:27-31, those people, they cried to Jesus. Jesus asked them a very directive question. You know, Jesus there, I was just thinking about what Jesus did there. They cry, Son of David, Son of David. Son of David, I think others had leprosy, others, there were many, many problems. But Jesus says, do you believe I can do this? These are the people who are crying. They are crying on the top of their voice, but Jesus called them and said, oh, sorry, do you believe I can do this? Jesus could not just offer healing for free. He knew. He gave them instruction and says, if I heal you must keep quiet. He knew that these guys, they were there for healing, but not to follow his instruction. But they cried, oh, Jesus, you can heal her, you can. So do you believe I can do that? Okay, receive it. When they receive, Jesus said, don't tell anybody. When they tell, he said, hey, he said, we must not tell anybody. He said, he is the one who healed us. They were outside of the instructions. Jesus could not deny to give them. But he wanted them to have instructions of their healing. But he could see that they could not hold those instructions. He asked them a simple question. They agreed. He healed them. They carry on doing what they say he must not do. Can I tell you this? If really you have compassion of God, whether God bless you or not, there are instructions. The instructions are required from you. If you carry on with the instructions, you'll be a blessing. I don't know if you're hearing me. That's always my friend. Whether you are blessed or poor, when God raised you, there are instructions. These instructions, it's not only for you, it's for other people. You know, it's possible. It's possible that people can still say, these people are lying. There was no way that these people could not even hide this miracle. I don't know if you're hearing me. If people knows that you have got leprosy, or you are blind, no one can hide that miracle. This is the worst nightmare of the time. Can you receive what God wants to give you with instruction? Receive that miracle with instruction. Listen, the instructions keeps you going. He blesses you by compassion. But he loves you to carry the instruction. If you believe, shout hallelujah. In Mark 1:40-42, this man had leprosy also. There we were talking about blind man.
His
leprosy. Jesus was moved by compassion. Jesus could, one of the gifts he had is compassion. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Look at Ezekiel 16:16. Let's read that one.
Are you
Asaba, do you have compassion? Let me read. Nevertheless, I will remember with compassion my covenant with you in the days of your youth, and I will establish an everlasting covenant with you. Can you see that?
Amen.
Look at that verse there. Only that verse.
Verse 60, and I will fail.
Covenant is coming from promise. The promise that we agree on, it becomes covenant.
Here
God was saying, I have promised and we agree on. Because of compassion, all the promises will come to pass. Can you see our God of compassion? Though you think time is gone, if you can read there, you realize that he says the covenants of youth, you know, I will remember them because of compassion. You know, when you were young, you used to dream, I want to be a doctor, I want to be an engineer. God has not forgotten that. You know, sometimes you look at yourself because of the outcomes of some disaster you went through. You ask yourself, if God is with me, why this? You sometimes crush some things. But God say, I will remember. I've given you a promise. I'll make sure that I carry it out. That promise is coming. You know, I was learning that there are things that in life you will never stop. One of it is time. It's just time.
Nako.
Time is going.
Nako ya tuwa.
Like this.
Kam nomho.
There are things that when you were young, you were able to do.
Jeding wao salomunya na uchona ludidira.
Let me give an example. When you're young, you used to steal sugar.
Ah, salomunya na usinju unju utswa swikiri.
Put it in the pocket.
We lokele kara potla buruho.
When you are in the class, you are sitting there. The teacher is ready there.
Teacher
you put your finger in your mouth. You put it there.
While lokela kara pota wabuyali swikiri waija.
And the teacher just see the head
and
going up.
And the teacher unawana letoli yahodi.
Are you asking question?
Ubuchia position angwanaka.
And you are finishing sugar. You say no.
We now fetch a swikiri kara pota wara auwa.
But now you are diabetic.
Jano anano unalindo bariki diabetes.
It's caused by the same sugar. So now, God says, I will remember that you used to eat sugar, but now you can't eat it. And I bring that sugar. Can you see how God, he knows the mistake, the challenges we are going through. He knows that our ability is faded. There's a level whereby, you know, when you walk on the street, you hear boys say, those who press the bell say,
Baba pressing the bell, Baba shapa the bell.
Even now when you buy expensive perfume, you walk on the road there, no one press a bell, no one says,
shishishish.
You just hear people say, Magogo,
how are you?
How are you, Magogo? But when God said, I will remember, he's referring to that. He says the hopes of a Christian cannot fade because of time. That's what God is saying. He says, okay, if now you think the time is gone, not in myself. I know when you were young, you had dreams. Now they are finished because you are old. But I'm bringing them back. You will dream dreams. It's what the Bible says. It says, in the last days, I will pour my spirit. The old will dream dreams. He was referring to that the Holy Spirit will come again. You'll be like a new person. You dream like a new person. I don't know if you are hearing that. If you believe, say, I believe. There are some people here today that God is raising right now as we are speaking. The compassion of God is coming upon your life. It's coming upon your life. God knows what you went through. He knows your challenges. He knows your past. He knows what you are going through. Today is your day. It's your day to go forward. It's your day to dream again. It's your day to see again. Your vision must be clear. If you believe, shout,
hallelujah.
Can you see that? God works that way. He wants you to say, no, I used to do this, but I can even do it double now. Can you stop undermining yourself because of what you went through? God wants you to dream again. Sometimes you look at yourself, you look down, you look at your family, and you question why all this. And God is saying, you are the solution of the family. You are the solution of that family. If you believe, shout
hallelujah.
I don't forget the day that when I was in UK, I was doing one in UK. Day. And I told you this story several times. When the old lady walking like this, and then I asked her, I said, how old are you, Mama? Because of what she told me. She said, I'm 77 years. I said, Mama? She says, I want to marry. I want to marry. I want to wed me. But she was working like this. I said, why are you saying that? She says, yes, UK.
Aramoki UK, wanaka.
Yes, UK.
UK mo.
It's not Africa.
As in South Africa, it's Africa.
She was wearing something like a wig here.
Na parent yo tsona le wiki moto.
Walking like this.
Atsama yo tsona le kuku wa nedi.
And she come and sit in front of me and say, I want to marry.
Ata dula pele ya ka rna ke nyoko nyana.
In the beginning I thought, is it a demon? Can I cast this demon? Ke
demon ne na ke ya le kuba na.
Because I'm coming from Africa.
Ka rna ke tswa Africa.
In Africa you know this is
Africa.
Kuku.
Ya tsebo re ba ke kuku
ba. I can't tell you that.
Ene kuku ka su bu tshilo
tshi tshwa. But in the Bible.
Mara go me le Bible
kuku. Kuku is still so young.
O sali o monyane.
I don't know if you're hearing
that. Anke tsebo le Antwana.
If you read about kuku.
Ha ka bala botseka taba ya kuku. Mo le ntsheng la modimo.
You find the old kuku.
O tlo re kuku la ga le Sara.
Who had a pregnant.
O ila ba le mpa.
The womb died.
Mpo ya ga e fuile mara ya tsosuloshwa.
Let your dreams be revived today. If you believe, shout
amen.
You need to dream again. Maybe somebody say, can't marry you again. Or somebody say, can't get married with you. Dream a white wedding. Dream it. Don't look down on yourself because of the rejection. Believe God. God can take you forward. Today, today is your time. If people are saying you won't make it in life, I'm here to tell you, you can make it, you can make it, you can make it. The compassion of God is upon you. Listen, when the compassion of God is upon you, even when things is like it's falling, it doesn't fall. I don't know if you hear me. Even when it's like now, you are running to zero account. It doesn't run there. When the compassion of God is upon you, God revives things and crash like it has never, like nothing has ever happened. He puts you in a level where somebody, when he looks at you, he does not understand your history or your geography. Can I prophesy? If you are here, you are the one that God is raising right now. I see God raising you. I see God raising you. I see God raising you. I see He's raising you. They say to you, nothing will happen. I'm saying in the spirit of the living God that something is happening right now, right here. They say to you, you won't be anointed. I say to you, today, you are receiving anointing. They say to you, you won't make it in life. I say, yeah, you are making it today. Those who think you won't make it, they'll be surprised by the time of your testimony. They say to you, they're talking many things, and they don't know the compassion of God upon your life. Take somebody and say, hey, I'm not alone. The Lord is on my side. He is on my side. The compassion of God has crushed my past. And victory is my portion. Hey, when I talk, listen, when I talk about this, I can see that our history, where you were born, does not matter. Does not matter. Where you are working does not matter. Where you are staying does not matter. What people are saying about you does not matter. What people are talking about your parents does not matter. What matters is the compassion of God upon my life. A compassion of God upon your life. I feel that love. Sit down. Today, the Ndozviyamakashuven.
I will speak in my own language.
Muzimu vadoniraverisa.
God will look at you with an eye of compassion.
Mato auri nishone.
The eyes of you being ashamed.
Mato auri inwi nishone.
The eyes of you being ashamed.
Mato auri vone vashone.
The eyes of making you to be ashamed.
Muzimu vado avura uri
avone uri anongoshona. God is going to open them so that they can see that there is something.
Ndichipinga chauri muzimu vavonare.
This is the time of God to be visible.
Ndichipinga.
The time of God to be visible.
Muzimu vangasitende uvhara mato.
God will never allow to close the eyes of your enemy. God will open the eyes of your enemy and open also your ears so that he can hear that you will never fail again. This is your time, this one. This is my time now. Tell the person that is close to you, this is my time. Tell the person again, this is my time. Tell the person again, it's my time. Tell him again, it's my time. Tell him again, it's my time.